Good afternoon all, respected Rajiv sir, respected Vivekananda sir, and respected respected Mr. sir and my relatives. And I am Rajiv sir. A grand welcome to the 161 seminar of our department. So 160 seminar of our Department of Physics was held on 21st September 2022 in the presence of all faculty members in Nidigarh. Today, on 12th October 2022, 161 seminar of our department is going to be held on Nidigarh. So, the seminar is going to be narrated by two speakers. First, Trigarshan Bari on the topic of superfluidity, and then Pranav Prakash Mishra on the topic of log wind detector. Now, welcome Trigarshan Bari to present with that each topic.
Respected teachers and my dear friends, my name is Trigarshan Bari. I am going to present my seminar topic. The topic is superfluidity. These speakers solve the superfluidity with an unknown specific. So, this fluid feel that container empty or becomes empty, so this fluid that non-viscosity. These are my contents. First, you discuss about the introduction, history, properties of superfluid, examples of superfluid, superfluidity of liquid helium, theoretical explanations of superfluidity, application, conclusion, reference. Introduction. Superfluidity is the characteristic property of fluid which has zero viscosity, so that the relative motion between its various layers is zero. So if flow without any loss of kinetic energy, the fluid which solves this property is called a superfluid. Then when you are a superfluid, it forms vortices which continues till the after surrounding medium is a surrounding medium is superfluid in nature. So the superfluid vortices, they are continuing to rotate indefinitely. Superfluidity occurs in two isotopes of helium. We all know that helium has 9 isotopes, out of which helium 3 and helium 4 are stable. And the natural abundance of helium 3 is 0.002% and helium 4 is 99.998%. So helium 3 and helium 4 generally solve the superfluidity nature at cryogenic temperature. It is also a property of various exotic states of matter. Exotic means the states of matter which violate the laws of physics. So exotic states of matter theoretically exist in astrophysics, high energy physics, and theories of quantum gravity. Superfluidity is coincidental with Bose-Einstein condensation. But that Bose-Einstein condensation and superfluid are not equal. The neither phenomenon is directly related to other. Or not all Bose-Einstein condensates can be regarded as superfluids, and not all superfluids are Bose-Einstein condensates. Then I will discuss about the discovery of superfluidity. In 1908, Carnot Linde once first liquefied helium at the University of Leiden in Netherlands. By 1924, no one had made any measurement of superfluidity. Measurements of liquid, but by 1924, one had made precise measurements of liquid helium density and found out that at the temperature where the density was twice half maximum at about 2.20 Kelvin. This temperature is nearly 2.17 Kelvin. at which William becomes a superfluid. In 1927, William Simpson and Mike Zylokowski concluded that liquid helium under the gaseous condition at above 2.2 Kelvin. And this temperature is called the lambda point because the graph between specific heat and temperature equal with the Greek letter lambda. This is called lambda temperature. The two phases are called liquid helium 1 and helium 2. So helium 1 is the normal liquid or normal fluid and helium 2 is the superfluid. That story is remarkable as well that helium 2 is a superfluid was first discovered in 1937 and published in January 1938 by Soviet physicist Tyler Kapitsa and interpreted by Canadian physicist John F. Harlin and M.P. Williams. Then I will discuss about the properties of superfluid. First, superfluidity results in some strange phenomena. Strange phenomena means which are unexpected phenomena. That gives us So, strange phenomena that are not observed in ordinary liquid tanks together. So, superfluidity only occurs in strange phenomena. Ordinary liquid observed is not observed in ordinary liquid and gas. Then, as some superfluid such as helium 3 creep up the wall of the container, flow over the side, creep up. Eventually escape the container until the container becomes empty. This leaking behavior or stream flow actually does occur in a few normal fluids also, such as alcohol, petroleum, but this is not due to superfluidity. This is due to personal condition. This leakers are the superfluidity nature. This is a superfluid flow. The liquid helium is in the superfluid state and that means invisible film creeps off the inside wall of the valve and down on the outside. A drop forms. It will fall off into the liquid helium below. This will repeat until the top is empty or because the top is empty and the surrounding medium in the state of superfluidity provided the liquid helium superfluid and the below is also liquid helium, superfluid. Then the second property, superfluid can pass through the walls of container. That all liquid and gas. Superfluid can the container that holds the superfluid, it can pass through the walls of the container to outside. Thus, if you steer a superfluid, it forms vertices that continue to spin indefinitely. If the surrounding medium is in the state of superfluid and in superfluid state, both normal fluid and superfluid coexist. But the, when we reduce the temperature, then more and more superfluid creates and the amount of normal fluid becomes less. Turning a container of a superfluid does not disturb its content. If we turn a container of superfluid that holds the superfluid, the superfluid does not disturb. Because if we rotate a cup of coffee, some of the liquid moves with the cup. But in case of a superfluid, it does not disturb the container of superfluid. Does not disturb. A superfluid acts like a mixture of normal fluid and a superfluid. As the temperature drops, more of the fluid is superfluid and less of it is in an ordinary temperature. If temperature becomes lower, the superfluid, the amount of superfluid increases and the amount of ordinary fluid increases. Some superfluid display high thermal conductivity and then compressibility of different superfluids are different. Because some superfluids are compressible while others have low compressibility. For example, superfluid helium has low compressibility and superfluid Bose-Einstein condensate has no compressibility. Superfluidity is not associated with superconductivity. For example, superfluid helium 3 and helium 4 are both electrical insulators. Then I will discuss about the various examples of superfluid. Superfluid helium-4 is the best study example of super plate. With the help of super plate first, we can describe various super fluidity characteristics. Helium first transition from a liquid into a super plate, just a few degrees below its boiling point. The boiling point of helium first is first Kelvin or minus 269 degrees centigrade or minus 452 degrees centigrade. Or if we decrease the temperature further, then at nearly 2.17 Kelvin, helium for liquid becomes super. Super fluid for helium for looks like a normal pure liquid. However, because it is not dense, not viscosity, once it starts flowing, it continues moving past any obstacle. So the relative motion between its various layers is zero. So there is no viscosity. If it starts flowing, it continues to move indefinitely. This is a normal atom helium current. Then other examples of superfluid are superfluid helium 1, superfluid helium 3, some Bose-Einstein condensers as superfluid, not all. Bose-Einstein condensers are not superfluid. Atomic rubidium 85, lithium per atom at temperature 50 nanokelvin. Atomic sodium, possibly inside neutron star, superfluid vacuum theory, considered a vacuum as also a superfluid. This is a neutron star. The core is unknown and the second layer is superconducting proton, and the third layer is neutron superfluid, and the outermost layer, that is crust, is made up of crystalline iron. Superfluidity of liquid is helium. Superfluidity occurs only in certain substances under special conditions. At only special condition we get superfluidity nature at definite temperature and pressure. Under standard pressure and temperature, helium is a gas. It liquefies at temperature nearly 4 Kelvin. That is the boiling point of helium gas. Cooling further down, it enters the superfluid phase at temperature nearly equal to 2 Kelvin. Precisely, you can say 2.17 Kelvin, depending on pressure. Natural helium consists of essentially of isotopes of helium. Naturally, helium consists of the major part of helium and less part of helium. This graph shows the four stages are coexisting. Superfluid, normal, liquid, solid, and gas. Superfluid in stage phase is also called as helium 2i phase, and normal fluid is helium 1. At temperature 2.15 megapascal and below, we get a superfluid. Phase diagram of helium 4 at low temperature, helium 4 remains liquid at zero temperature. If the pressure is below 2.5 megapascal, nearly 425 atm, the liquid has a phase transition, or the liquid converts into a superfluid phase, also known as helium 2i, at temperature of 2.17 Kelvin at vapor pressure. Helium has another stable isotope, helium 3. As the temperatures below a few Kelvin, its behavior is radically different from the isotope of helium 4. Helium 3 and helium 4. If we decrease the temperature of helium 4, the property is totally different from helium 3. The property of helium 3 is totally different from helium 4. It also becomes superfluid, but at temperatures that are a factor of 1000 smaller than that for helium 4. That is, helium 4 is in normal Kelvin temperature, but helium 3 becomes a superfluid at milli Kelvin. Helium 3 has three different superfluid types. Unlike helium 4, helium 3 has three different superfluid types, A1 and B. The A1 phases appears only in a magnetic field and therefore is not visible in figure 3. This figure shows the x-axis is temperature in millikelvin, the y-axis is pressure in megapascal. this is there are two superfluid phases, superfluid B phase, superfluid A phase. A1 is not seen in that figure because it is only seen in magnetic phase. The figure shows the phase diagram of helium 3 at low temperature. Not that the temperature is in units of millikelvin. Two superfluid phases of helium 3 A and B are shown based on data by GS. Theoretical explanation of superfluidity. We can consider the system of superfluid a single coherent quantum mechanical wave function. The accepted theoretical understanding of superfluidity based on the idea that an extremely large number of atoms so identical in quantum mechanical level. So it is basically a quantum mechanical concept. The helium 4 liquid consists of atoms. That have to do. Helium 4 atom has total angular momentum 0 and spin is integral. So it is a boson particle, the atom of helium 4 is a boson particle. So it is follow Bose-Einstein statistic or simply Bose statistic. A gas of such atoms or helium 4 atoms without interacting between them would undergo at some temperature T0 a phenomenon known as Bose condensation. At some temperature T0, the atoms of helium 4 undergo Bose condensation. So, if we decrease the temperature also below T0 temperature, a finite fraction of all atoms occupy a single state. Normally, the atom lowest energy. Now, this state has lowest energy, and this fraction increases towards 1 as the temperature falls towards absolute 0. If we decrease the temperature towards the absolute 0 Kelvin, then this fraction, the amount of this fraction increases. These atoms are said to be quantum. So that we can say that these atoms are said to be quantum. It is widely believed that a similar phenomenon should also occur for helium for liquid such as helium 4, in which interaction between atoms is quite important. And that the lambda transition of helium 4 is just the onset of Bose condensation. When the liquid is flowing through a small capillary, the condensed atoms cannot be scattered by the walls one at a time, since they are forced by Bose statistics to occupy the cell. If we scatter only one atom, then it can be scattered, but the all atoms cannot be scattered by the walls of the small capillary. They must be scattered if at all simultaneously. If we scatter them simultaneously, then they must be scattered. Since this process is extremely improbable, the liquid or more precisely the condensed fraction of it flows without any apparent reason. So that the friction is zero, so that they move with no viscosity. The idea of Bose condensation is not directly applicable to liquid helium 3. Unlike helium 4, the concept of Bose condensation is not directly applicable to helium 3. Because helium 3 atoms have spin, the spin of helium 3 atom is half multiple of h by 2 pi, and the spin and the angular momentum is different. Therefore, their distribution among states is therefore believed to be governed by a different reason, that is Fermi statistic. If helium 3 atom is a Fermi particle by virtue of its half integral spin, the spin of helium 3 particle is half integral. It is believed that in the superfluid phase of helium 3, the atoms pair up to form copper pairs. In case of helium 3 superfluid, the helium 3 atoms form copper pairs. The copper pairs is a sort of quasi molecular complex, so that now the copper pair has integral spin and therefore it obeys Bose-Einstein condensation with not follow Fermi statistics. In particular, as soon as the copper pairs are formed, they undergo a sort of Bose condensation. So now helium 3 undergo a sort of Bose condensation or follow Bose condensation, and subsequently the arguments given above for helium per apply equal to W. So this concept of helium per is applied to helium 3 also. In helium 3, the atom shares with parallel spin. Unlike helium 4, helium 3 atoms pair with parallel spin. And the angular momentum of helium 3 is non-zero, so that the internal structures of pairs is more richer and more interesting. So the internal structure is different from helium 4. Therefore, there are three superfluid pairs. Unlike helium 4, here for helium 3 there are three superfluid edges called A, B and A1, which are distinguished by different internal structures of copper. We can distinguish them by the help of copper gas. Some of the superfluid properties of the phase A1 and A and A1 are different from those of helium 4 and helium 3B and are emitted unique among non-physical systems. Application. Superfluids can be used in various ways. Superfluids have various applications. Superfluids can be used to study superconductivity and make superconducting magnets. With the help of superfluids, we can make superconducting magnets. These are different from general magnets. In making a nanofreeze, superfluids are also used in making nanofreeze. Nanofreeze generally stores protein molecules which are desperate at room temperature. Superfluid can be used to reduce speed of light. With the help of superfluid, we can reduce the speed of light as quantum solvent. Quantum solvent is generally a superfluid which dissolves other chemical species in infrared astronomical satellite. IRAS, infrared astronomical satellite, is the first satellite which measure define the sky in night by the help of infrared wavelength. It is also used in gyroscopy. There are various applications of superfluid in medical field. Normal fluid is composed of buoyancy particles because the force of attraction between the particles of a normal fluid is cohesive force, whereas a superfluid is a collection of individual particles without force. Because in case of superfluid, there is no cohesive force. The unique properties of superfluids are caused by the absence of inter-particle attraction. The unique properties of superfluid has a unique property that are caused by absence of inter-particle attraction. There is no inter-particle attraction. The attraction between helium molecules can be eliminated primarily due to its unique atomic structure. The atomic structure of superfluid is different. So that is the combination of small atomic size. Here the atomic size is small and even distribution of electrons. The number of electrons is even. Intermolecular attraction are always present between molecules with uneven electron distribution. We know that intermolecular attraction are always present between molecules with uneven electron distribution. If the number of electrons is uneven, then there is present intermolecular attraction. Because here the number of electrons is even, so there is no intermolecular attraction. Molecules with an even distribution of electrons are there. Molecules with the even distribution of electrons, that is, the molecules have the number of electrons is even, are there, which is insufficient to explain superfluids. So that it is insufficient to explain superfluids. These are the references.